Hello everyone, Iris Franz here. Today we will continue to talk about the long-run average total cost curve. In particular, we will discuss economies of scale, constant returns to scale, and diseconomies of scale, their definition, and what happens when a firm goes through these three stages. Economies of scale occurs when the average total cost drops while the firm's output expands. Constant returns to scale is a condition where the long-run average total cost remains the same as the output expands. Diseconomies of scale is a condition where the long-run average total cost rises as the output expands. Here are some causes of economies of scale. When the firm is expanding, it will start to purchase more resources and get a quantity discount. We experience this ourselves. When we buy in bulk at Costco, the unit cost is lower. In addition, when the firm is expanding, the firm is going to experience capital efficiency. For instance, we use the same one kitchen to cook either 5 plates of food or 50 plates of food. It is clear that we are using the kitchen more efficiently when we are producing 50 plates of food than just 5 plates of food. Third, the firm will benefit from labor specialization. Imagine a small Japanese restaurant initially has only one chef. The chef must be very busy coming to the sushi bar in front to make sushi and then rush back to the kitchen to make ramen. As the restaurant expands, the owner can hire another chef. Now one chef can focus on sushi bar orders while the other stays in the kitchen to make only ramen. The two chefs can work a lot more efficiently than just one chef. As a result, the long-run average total cost goes down. Finally, as the firm expands, the owner can now hire different managers for different departments. Specifically, the owner can hire the HR manager, the accounting manager, and maybe a purchasing department manager. Each one focuses on only one managerial task. You can imagine that this managerial specialization will be more efficient than the owner doing everything alone. As the firm continues to expand, the benefits of a greater quantity gradually wears off. As such, the firm experiences a stage where the long-run average total cost remains the same, which we call constant returns to scale. Finally, when the firm becomes very large, the long-run average total cost will start to rise, which we call diseconomies of scale. There are several reasons for diseconomies of scale. First, large firms have many departments, sometimes located in different regions or even different continents. This makes coordination among departments challenging, which increases the cost. In addition, compared to a small firm, a very large firm will have more communication issues. To communicate, a firm will hold meetings. For a large firm, sometimes in preparation for an important meeting with the CEO and CFO, a small department must hold pre-meetings. All these meetings are extremely costly as it takes time away from the employees to work on their tasks. Therefore, the long-run average total cost goes up. Finally, as a firm becomes very large, it is harder to monitor shirking. If employees are shirking and not working, then productivity drops and cost rises. This concludes our mini video about economies of scale, constant returns to scale, and diseconomies of scale. I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.